Hello guys, welcome back again in the new video of Power Learning channel. So in today's video, I will explain you the generator common problems. What are the common problems of generator and how we will solve it easily? If you are new on my channel, so kindly subscribe this channel now, because I am making all the videos related to electric generator, control system, control panels and diesel generator mechanical issues. So my dear friend, you are watching Power Learning channel. So in today's video, we will learn about the common issues of diesel generator starting problem due to maintenance or due to any possible cause. Okay, because diesel generators, if you are not maintaining good, okay, they will make a big problem for you. So it is better to maintain always your generator on time. So I will explain you in this video what is the diesel engine oil we are using and which grade of oil you will use. So all these things will be covered in this video. So let's get started. So my dear friend, once you are a technician or engineer or you are working for diesel generator or you are an operator, so it is really important that you know what are the basic function of diesel generator starting and what system is helping us to start the diesel engine. Okay, so first of all, in every diesel generator, what parts we have? So we have diesel engine, alternator, control panel and main breaker. Okay, these are the main system of diesel generator. In diesel engine, we have different systems like air system, okay, oil system, water system, okay, and filtration system. Okay, so once we are facing problem regarding the diesel generator starting, so we have to know these basic things in our mind, that what is the function of fuel system, what is the function of oil system, what is the function of cooling system, because this will help us in finding out the problem in our diesel generator. Mostly in diesel generator we are facing problem in engine side, because it is a complete genset and we have a controller and we have alternator, so we also know about the other aspects of the problem. Okay, for a good technician or a good engineer, you must know mechanical, electrical and also the controller alarms and event logs. So first of all, once you are stuck at site, don't be get confused. Okay, just start from the basics. Okay, that what are the basics, so I should know that what is the problem came in this generator. So once you are start with the basics, so you will easily troubleshoot your generator problem. Okay, so first of all, I will explain you now. Look, diesel engine is operated by diesel fuel. So once there is a problem in your generator, just check first fuel, that fuel is available in the diesel tank or no. So for this, you will check your fuel level indicator, which is located on your diesel tank. If you are using external tank, so just check the supply is okay and the diesel tank level is showing full. Okay, the next basic thing is related to battery. This is very important. Battery, you should check while your battery is charged, not charged, what is your charging status. Okay, especially in standby sites, sometime we see customer didn't install the static charger, so due to this the generator battery got down and it is having low voltage. So once you are cranking, so engine is not starting. Okay, so this is the second case. First you have to check diesel. The second thing, you have to check battery switch, battery fuses. Okay, this you will check via multimeter or on your control panel. After that, go on your control panel, just check there what is the voltage it's showing on the controller, and now press the manual mode button and start button and start your engine. If your engine is crank, okay, it is showing you that it is cranking, but you have to know with your experience that it is cranking and what is the voltage at the time of cranking. Okay, for example, if you are using 24 volt system generator, okay, and once you are cranking and your voltage it's going on 10 volt, so your generator will not start because your ignition system having less voltage for operating to pass the fuel. Okay, so always make sure once you are cranking, so your voltage should be around 18 to 19. This is normal and as per my experience. Okay, so after that, if you check your also for the main thing, the battery switches, okay, sometime we have problem in battery switch and even your generator is cranking but it is not getting the full voltage, okay, so due to this reason sometime we bypass the switch and then we operate and it is operating, okay. Sometime we are getting receiving the message on our controller that fail to stop, and once you are pressing any button like stop button, reset button, but it is not responding. It is a very commonly asked question. Lot of my friend on YouTube, they are asking me what is fail to stop. Sometime you are trying to reset this alarm but fail to stop, it's not resetting. So I will explain you now it is related to which sensor, okay, and why it is showing fail to stop. Just consider, just focus what I am saying, fail to stop. I am not saying fail to start. Fail to start different. This is I will talk you about this fail to start after this, but first thing, fail to stop. Okay, fail to stop means that you are, your generator is still sensing that it is running, okay, it is still running and it is not stopping. So once generator feeling, the controller is feel that the generator is in running stage, how you will start it again? So that's why it's inhibit the start function. So always check your oil pressure sensor. Only fail to stop alarm will come due to oil sensor faulty. If your oil sensor is faulty, you are not able to reset the fail to stop. So it means that your oil sensor is defected, so change it and after that you will able to start your genset. Okay, another thing, for example, if you try to start your generator and you press manual mode and start mode button, okay, and after that it is just cranking one time, then rest, then crank, then rest, then crank, and then it is show you fail to start. So now I am saying fail to start, that your engine is cranking, okay, and engine is cranking but not start after 3 attempts. So it's mean that there is a problem that fuel is not reaching, okay, or the fuel solenoid is not on, okay, or the fuel solenoid relay or fuse or wire, all these step you have to check start from your controller, okay, from your controller, like the output of your fuel fuel output which is energizing the fuel relay, the fuel relay contact, the fuel relay contact and the output supply of the fuel relay, and then check on the solenoid that it is complete turning on. Sometimes solenoid is damaged, so due to this issue even you have full 12 volt or 24 volt on your solenoid but it is damaged, so always remove it from the pump and check. Okay, we face this issue many times, so that's why I'm telling you, very important. Sometime we are just surrounding the generator and we are not finding anything, so better you have to put 12 volt direct from the battery to your solenoid and just crank it directly, so you will know. Okay, another thing related, once I found it the problem that we did a maintenance, okay, and we didn't fill the fuel filter and we fix it, our mechanic is fix the fuel filter empty before the generator is running, but after maintenance the generator stop running, generator is only cranking but not starting. So what happened in this case, because we remove the fuel filters, we put new filters and we are trying to start now generator again, okay, but there is no fuel because we make the air gap between the fuel system, the fuel system have now no fuel, even we are cranking so many times, so it is not start and even our battery is got down. So what we will do, we fill our fuel filter, or we loosen the fuel filter and we push the priming pump, okay, and then we remove the complete air from the fuel system, okay, from the fuel system. Now fuel is coming from return line. Just make sure your fuel is coming back bleeding from return line, okay. Once it is return line, okay, close it, tight the pipes or the injection, okay, everything you must tight it, and then crank. After that you will find your generator is started. Another case, in some cases we found that your starter is giving command, your solenoid is okay, but sometime the relay contact for the fuel, it's not giving signal. So always make sure that your relay is okay. Okay, another thing, sometime we start the generator but it's nearly coming to start and then stop. This is also I face one time. So what I find that this generator is 24 volt, and with governor, mechanical governor and actuator, once we are starting the voltage is going around 13 or 12, okay. So due to this reason the engine is cranking normally, it is showing no symptoms, okay, but the fuel system, the actuator, you know, it is fixed inside the pump, so we are not able to see what is the actuator state. So after wasting a time and so many efforts we did, we request from customer that bring two new batteries. We fix two new batteries and then we start the engine, so it start immediately. So these are the very very common things which is related to starting problem of the engine, okay. Another thing I want to add here, once you are a technician, always keep focus on your mind from the basic things like battery switch, like fuel level, like solenoid, like your relays, your controller output. These are very common and very important thing. Once you are a technician, you are a good technician, keep basic things. If you know the basic things, okay, in your mind, you will easily troubleshoot any kind of generator. But just go step by step. Don't open all the things together. Check one by one, okay. One more thing regarding the charging system of the generator. In so many prime application generator, we are using only one charger which is called dynamo, okay. But in standby system, mostly companies, they are not providing the battery charger, static battery charger. Static battery charger is also very important for the standby sites. If you are your generator installed at a standby site, okay, you must have to make sure that it is charging while in standby mode. So you have to install the static charger in your generator, okay. The static charger is charging during the rest time of the generator, during the standby period, because during standby period your controller is consuming power, and once the power is off, engine try to start the engine, so it is not starting because the battery level already consumed by controller and the relays. So at the time of starting, it is not starting due to low battery. So this is also a very common problem. And make sure if you are operating generator like in desert area or other areas, always make sure that fuel is very clean, your air filter is very clean, okay. And what are the normal period of servicing of your generator, okay. Every 250 hours you have to change oil filter and fuel filter, okay, and clean air filter. Every 1000 hour change the engine belts. So these are the common things for maintenance. Some people, they are doing at 500 hours fuel filter. Is it also okay? But it is depending on your fuel quality, okay. So these are the common problem of starting, okay. And now I will explain you, if your generator is started and after that it will be stopped, so it will also depend on engine and also on alternator. Sometime if you start the engine and after few seconds, once the safety timer is off, you will get under voltage alarm. So now you have to see first of all which is under voltage. It is DC under voltage or AC under voltage. Just go and check the alarm which is showing on your controller. What is this alarm? it is under voltage related to DC or AC. Don't get confused between AC and DC. DC we are using for charging the generator battery, and AC is we are producing from our alternator. If it is showing low voltage shutdown, okay, and it is writing in the event log generator low voltage. So generator low voltage related to AC alternator. Okay, so first of all, you will check with your on your screen in generator section voltage, run the generator again and check if the three phase voltage line to line and line to neutral, is it okay or no. If you find any phase missing, check your fuses which is installed inside the control panel. After that, if the fuses are okay, continuity are okay, check the wire between alternator and your fuses. Sometime the thimbles are get broken of the control wire, okay, so we will not get. So what is the good procedure without opening the alternator? Just put just check the voltage on your breaker, on your breaker with your multimeter. So you will see, okay, if the three phase voltage is there, so it's mean your neutral wire, your phase wire or any neutral wire is get broken from inside of alternator. Open the alternator, okay, and replace it with the new thimble and fix it. So this is the also common problem we are facing after starting. Also after starting, if we are receiving low oil pressure sensor, okay, or switch. So also here we have two protection in your generator, which is low oil pressure sensor and low oil pressure switch. If it is stop on low oil pressure or low oil pressure temperature, low oil pressure switch or sensor, so then you have to see which input is activated. It is low oil pressure analog sensor or digital input. Okay, first you will check and after that you will replace this sensor if the sensor is damaged. So my dear friend, this is very common things. Also in next video I will explain you some more about protection system and the safeties which sometime having problem in our generator. So I will explain you. Keep watching Power Learning channel. Thank you very much. Have a nice day. Assalamualaikum.